beautiful viewers, how are you today? I hope you're doing well. My name is Natalia. If you don't familiar with my channel and me, I'm actually an holistic vocal coach and I help people transform their voices and their lives along the way. And also I'm a professional crossover singer. So today I'm gonna react to your requests. So as you know, I don't need to say anything. Just put them in the comments, your requests. Who you want to meet, to react to next, your thoughts, everything in the comment section below. I promise I'm commenting and chatting and liking your comments, and I always love to see that more and more. But that was a very interesting request because Adagio is one of my favorite songs and I keep singing this in every performance and every chance I can with my partner Gilad, with, you know, whoever, duet or by myself, and it's one of my favorite songs. And I want to hear Laura Britain, I don't know, to sing that. So before we're gonna dive in, just making sure you're part of the family. So all you gotta do is just hit the subscribe and also click the bell so you get a notification every single time I'm uploading your request. And if you're singers, this is the place for you guys not only to subscribe but also be part of my free 7-day vocal challenge. All you gotta do is to click the first link in the description bar below and it will direct you to my website and you'll search your name and your email and I'll send you to your inbox right away. So guys, with no further ado, let's start reacting. Okay. Okay, a little drama going on here. Let's see.
Thank you.
that was beautiful, beautiful, beautiful arrangement. I knew it was him. I knew it was him. I was about to say. So Giora Lindberg, he's from Israel. And he actually signed a huge contract with Universal Records. And since he worked with Edith Piaf, oh my God, I'm completely losing it, Lara Fabian, and I could hear his arrangement. I didn't even look at it, and I'm seeing it, and I'm like, oh, I know this sound. And I was about to say it was beautiful arrangement, and I'm so happy to see his name. That's so awesome. Okay, I mean, edit and mix in Ron Aviv and Aviv Studio. I see what's going on here. Fantastic. Okay, this is not a done live. This is a video. Obviously, she took probably many takes, and this was a work in progress. But I really want to address something beautifully, some of the beautiful things she did in this song. This song is obviously very heavy, very dramatic, and she's a very young singer. And her voice is really interesting combination between Christina Perry, very light, airy, very vulnerable. She can sing very kind of light, but very flexible at the same time. And as I say, very vulnerable. And all the way to the more heavy, to the more kind of operatic, without using losing her youngness and her voice and her approach and her attitude. So it's a very interesting combination, and she's right now in that transition. Now, since I am a crossover singer, this is couldn't be the most perfect thing for me to see, because I understand what she's going through. And, you know, having your voice function in two different ways and shift that in the middle of the song, it's not an easy thing, right? It's all a matter of also taste. So there's no wrong or right. It's just, you know, everybody can look at it in a different way. But it's very interesting to find that middle ground, what it actually works, what it doesn't sound like you're just forcing the opera in there to make it sound like opera, where it actually fits in. And I think she done a beautiful job by starting very innocent and light. And I have to tell you, I love that. And I actually wish she would stay there. I think this song, as much as you can show and express and kind of impress with your range and all those things, which she did beautifully in the end, I think if she would stay in that same color from beginning till the end, and of course, when she's going to those transpositions, and when she goes to the high voice, and in the end, and she goes to that high note, that is great to put the opera there. But I think this song wasn't done in a more kind of a simpler, kind of Christina Perry type of very simple, but very honest, very raw, very airy, very flexible, very like giving me a little bit of runs here and there, some trills, something very kind of the way exactly where she started. And I think if she continue that and give me a little bit of more mix there, and then that just the kickers of you know, just the little dots of the opera in there, especially when she vocalizing, that will work better. I just know the song so well, and knowing voice that is singing in more kind of contemporary way, pop way, where it's not as cover, where you actually kind of using more of your chest. And I think right now there's a beautiful kind of like return of a simple voice. You don't have to use your voice in such a grandiose way. And I think this is such an awesome, awesome song that instead of taking it so big and grandiose, taking it in a little bit more simpler way, I think it would even work even more better. So again, it's not wrong, right? It's just something that when I hear it, and I know this song so well, and I know Giora, and I know, I feel her voice, I know exactly what's going on there. And I think, you know, it's a very interesting thing to find that balance, but she did a great, great job vocally, I have to tell you, from beginning to end. And again, I don't know her in terms of her live singing, how she's doing it. It's obviously a music video, it's a completely different you know, it's not as, I would say, raw as standing on stage and from beginning to end, have no takes, no whatsoever, and just deliver. But I have to tell you, it was tastefully done. It was connected emotionally from beginning to end, even though she went to the opera thing, it doesn't matter. And I think she did such a beautiful take on this song. And I mean, again, this song is very, very hard. Emotionally, there's a lot of transpositions, there's a lot of things in there, and she kept it honest, she kept it real. And that's what I like the most about her. That's so cool. Like the fact that I saw his name right now, Giora, I'm like, this is crazy. It's my Facebook friend, and I'm just like, it's just so funny how this world is so small after all, right? But this is awesome, awesome to see. Now, so let me know if I should react to something else. I would love to see a live performance of this young, beautiful lady. And should I do a cover for you guys for this song? What do you think? Would you want that? Let me know by, you know, just commenting below, you know, Adagio, sing us Adagio, and I will definitely record this for you guys. And so let me know what else should I react to from Lara. And also, if you are not part of the family already, this is the time to hit the subscribe. And also, if you're singers, this is time to be part of my free 7-day vocal challenge. And as you know, it's right there waiting for you in the first link in the description bar below. So guys, I can talk and talk forever about this song. I just love this song so much. And again, I think Lara did such a fantastic job delivering such a heart song in a very honest and sincere way, and to bring herself through that. And just overall, it was absolutely gorgeous video. She's beautiful, I'm not even addressing that. And her voice is just healthy, beautiful, and I really wish her nothing but the best. So yes guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in our next video. Bye.